I'm going to show you how to make nice plots of XY data, and we're first going to do a regression analysis. So I've got percent nitric acid, and we've got heat capacity. So this essentially is our independent variable, and this is our dependent variable, or the output. And to do regression in Excel, especially if we want to do polynomial, I need to move this over. And here we're going to have our x squared term and x cubed. And if I wanted, I could do x fourth, fifth, and so on. And now I just put in the formulas for these. And now I'm going to double click on that to autofill. Now I go over here to data, data analysis, regression. And for our input y, we're going to put that, making sure my labels box is clicked because I have that upper one. The label here on that first row, input X is going to be all these. That's going to be our input. And I'm just going to add a residuals. If you want, a lot of times I like to do residual plot, but that's not really necessary. So I've got my residuals, click OK. It spits out our output. I'm going to highlight those columns and auto resize by double clicking on a boundary between two of the columns up above. And now I've got my regression output. So these are the coefficients in our model. So our model looks like a plus bx plus cx squared plus dx cubed. These are the coefficients. The p-value, we want the p-value to be less than 0.05 for all of the terms, and that means that those terms are significant, and all of those are less than 0.05. If we did have one of these that was greater than 0.05, then that just means that that particular term is not needed in that model. And then another thing that's spit out because we clicked that residuals box is the predicted. So I'm just going to copy that. I'm going to bring this back over here, and I'm going to paste, and I'm going to just change the number of decimals that's shown. And one thing I'm going to do just to make it easier to plot, it's a lot easier to plot if you have X and then Y. So I'm going to move my X's back over here, and I can highlight this. If you highlight XY, you can just go up here to insert, chart, scatter. And so we've inserted that scatter diagram. We go over here to the plus sign, and I can add axis titles, and I'm going to rename this heat capacity, and I'm going to rename this percent HNO3. So now we've got that formatted. What we want to do is to leave these experimental data points. So these are the experimental heat capacities. We want to leave those as markers, and we want to add our model predictions. This is our model predicted. These I can copy. So I highlight those, Control C, and now if I just click once on the inside of that plot, and I do control paste, it adds that second set, assuming we have the same independent variables on the x-axis, which we do. So now I click on the pink dots. The pink dots represent our model predictions, but we want to make model predictions as a smooth line. So I'm going to right-click on that and format data series. It brings up the options over here. You click on the paint bucket, and I go to solid line. I'm just going to change that to, let's say, red. And then at the bottom of this box is a smooth line. So that's the preferred way, is to add a smooth line. And then I go here to marker, and I'm going to eliminate my markers by changing from automatic to none. And I'm going to X that box out, and now we have our model predictions, which is the red line, and we have our experimental data points, which are the blue dots. And that is how you make a nice plot of predicted versus actual for a regression analysis. Thanks for watching.